मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल सी अवर नेक्स्ट पॉइंट दैट इज अ प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल. सी यस्टरडे आई हैव गिवन यू नोट्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ PDF फाइल. इफ इट इज पॉसिबल फॉर यू टेक प्रिंट आउट, अदरवाइज राइट डाउन इन योर केमिस्ट्री अ नोटबुक. नाउ वी विल सी अवर नेक्स्ट प्रॉपर्टीज. सी ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस दिस टू प्रॉपर्टीज, दैट इज फिजिकल स्टेट एंड हार्डनेस ऑफ metals. Okay, so mostly all metals are in which state? Solid state. Mostly all metals are in a solid state. The exceptional cases are gallium and mercury. These both the metals are in a liquid state at room temperature. Now what is a room temperature? Room temperature means this normal temperature. Now see, I am standing here in this room. Whatever the temperature surrounding by us, that is a known as a room a temperature. So mostly all the metals are in a solid state at room temperature. Exceptional case, that is a gallium and what? Mercury. See, mercury you have seen. Mercury, where it is used? Mercury is used in thermometer. Okay, that see the red color liquid, it is there in that. So that is known as a mercury. So mercury is in a liquid state. Then see the second property is, that is hardness. Mostly all the metals are very hard. Okay, for example, iron. Now iron, you know how much it is hard, iron, copper. But in this also some exceptional case, that is a sodium is a soft metal. See, only one or two exceptionals are there, but that you have to remember it. Okay, so see, mostly all metals are very hard, but exceptional, that is sodium, is very soft metal and it can be cut by knife also. So this much it is very soft. Now see the next property, that is a luster. Now luster means what? See, luster means shine. Okay, what? Luster means a shine. See, just you have observed when your mother is washing utensils of copper. Okay, so what she is using for that? She pitambari, do you know that? She is using that. And afterwards, after washing that, you will see the shine on that utensils. Why? Because mostly all the metals are in lustrous a nature. Okay, so lustrous means what? Shine. So all the metals are very lustrous because they are having a shine. Now next thing, property C, ductility. Okay, now ductility means what? See, ductility, I have written here definition, the property due to which a substance can be drawn into a thin wire. See, these are very important. These two words are very important. The property due to which a substance can be drawn into a thin wire without breaking. Okay, means mostly the metals that can be converted into a thin wire. Thin wire, now for example, see the jewelry. Okay, now jewelry which we are using in our regular life. See, that means different designs are there. Okay, see gold, for example, gold, silver. So how this possible? How they made this in these designs? Why? Because the metals have the special property, and that property is known as a ductility. See, metal shows this ductility property, and because of this property, the metals can drawn into a thin wire. See, do you know that in these electric gadgets, the copper wire is used? See here in this picture also, I have given some examples that can be converted into a thin wire. Okay, so copper wire we use in this electric gadget. So how this possible? Because metal shows the ductility property. So you just have to remember, ductility means what? When metals drawn into a thin wire, that property is known as a ductility. Now here also some exceptions are there. Now you only tell me which are the exceptional case. That is a mercury. Okay, mercury and zinc, these two metals are in exceptional. Why? Because they cannot draw into a thin wire. Already mercury is in a liquid state. Now see, yesterday whatever the notes I have given you in that periodic table, and I shown you the properly which are the metals, which are non-metals, and which are a metalloids. So you just go through that. Okay, so this is, and see, thin wire without breaking, for example gold and a silver, just two examples I have written here, but mostly all the metals are shown a ductility property. Now see the next property, that is a malleability. Okay, what is a next property? Malleability. Now see, in this property what happened? The property due to which a substance can be beaten into a thin sheet without cracking. Means see, in this a substance, means that particular metal, can be converted into a thin sheet. See, in the ductility it can be converted into a thin wire, and in a malleability it can be converted into a thin sheet. Okay, so this property shows the malleability. See, the property due to which the substance can be beaten into a thin sheet means when you will hammer it, okay, when you will hammer it, it can be converted into a thin sheet without a cracking. Okay, so this is the property of the malleability. Mostly all the metal shows this property. Now for example, see, you are using the aluminium foil to wrap food atom. Yes, did you saw now that silver color paper? That silver color paper means what? It is a aluminium foil. So how this converted into a thin sheet? How this converted into a paper? Why? Because it shows the property of a malleability. Okay, so this is the next property, that is a malleability. Do you understand it? Okay, now see the next property, that is a conduction of heat and electricity. Now conduction of heat and electricity means what? It can conduct heat, okay, and electricity means a metals allow to conduct heat and electricity. For example, see, what utensils do you know? No utensils your mother is using every day in the kitchen. Okay, so while cooking food, if you will touch that particular utensils, then what will happen? You will get hurt. Okay, your skin will burn. Why? Because that utensils are made up of metals, and metals conduct heat and electricity. Okay, and because of that it conduct the electricity. So see, that pan, cooker, they are having a plastic handle. Okay, why plastic handle? Because plastic is a insulator. Insulator means what? It cannot conduct the heat and electricity. Okay, and conductors means those conduct heat and electricity are known as conductors. And plastic is an insulator because it cannot conduct heat and electricity. So see, mostly all the utensils that we are having a plastic handle, because of that we can handle it, that utensils, properly. See here, I have shown you some pictures. Okay, now it conduct heat and electricity. Now see, for example, Cu. okay, now Cu means what? Cu means copper, Ag silver. See, Silver is a best conductor of electricity. See, if anyone will ask to you which one is the best conductor of electricity, that is a silver. Okay, but silver is a best conductor of electricity, but even though we are using copper, why? What is the reason behind that? See, now in this gadget, what we are using? We are using a copper wire. Most commonly we are using copper wire. Why we are not using silver? Because silver is very expensive. Okay, and copper, it is a very, means it is very less amount we will get the copper, and because of that reason copper we are using, and copper is also metal, silver is a metal, so they are having the property to conduct heat and electricity. So because of that reason we are using the copper wires in the electric gadgets. Okay, see, one experiment, it is given in your textbook related to the conduction of heat. So that experiment we will conduct tomorrow. Okay, in tomorrow lecture we will see experiment. So now today what we learn, today we learn about these six physical properties of matter. See, first one is a physical state, hardness, luster, ductility, malleability, and conduction of heat and electricity. Do you understand these all the properties? If you have any doubts regarding any properties, please contact to me. So tomorrow we will see our experiment related to the conduction and some other properties of metals. Okay, so now we will stop here. Today your homework is read this lesson properly. Lesson means, see, maybe you have taken printout, otherwise write that all notes in your chemistry notebook. Read it properly. Okay, so tomorrow we will see our next point. Thank you.